But for now, welcome to Wild Earth. Welcome here at Juma. We're sitting very, very close to camp. It's just behind you. Pete's in the final control center. Herman behind the camera. My name is Peter. As many of you might know, some of you might not know yet, but we had an inverter problem last night, a technical thing on the vehicle. And Graham managed to source it, even though it's over the weekend and it's quite a difficult thing to find. Managed to find one in Nelspruit. And as we speak, Rex and Simon are on their way back from Nelspruit. We're expecting them here optimistically 5 o'clock, but otherwise just after 5, probably between 5 and 5.30. And as soon as they get here, it's about a 10-minute operation, then it'll be in the vehicle and we'll get out there for a later, there's a nice Afrikaans slip, a later part of the drive. So we will do a drive later on, and we will keep you updated as well before then if we get any more news from Rex and them as to how far they are. But for the moment, I would say, like I said, maybe 5, but realistically probably 5.30 we should be able to get out there for a drive. In the meantime, we just thought we'll say hello. It's a beautiful afternoon. You can see the sunlight is coming through gorgeously here from the towards the east. The sun getting lower already, and it should be a lovely afternoon later on as well. It was overcast the whole day. It's opening up a bit now. We've got some blue sky and warm sunlight coming through. So stunning, stunning day out here. And just decided to show you around a little bit. This morning we had an interesting bit of walk around the camp with some improvised planning, and experimented more today, and we should be able to show you more of this area. This log that I'm sitting on, or tree actually, it's still alive and will be hopefully for many years to come, is right here above the pond, or Peter's Pond. And it's been a while since we had a talk around here. It's been drastically changed. I've played around here a little bit, but more importantly, lots of wildlife have come and gone, and also elephants quite a bit. So it's been re-landscaped by elephants. Almost, I don't want to take a dive into the pond just yet. But this tree that I'm standing on used to be a vertical tree there, about halfway between me and you. Standing straight up, elephant came, pushed it over, he ate a lot of the roots and the bark at the root, and pushed this over, also broke a whole bunch of branches off this tree. So it's changed it quite a lot. I quite like it actually. When I got here, I was quite excited to see what's been done around here by the elephant gardening. So this tree will still be fine. As you look, or you can see down here, that's the main root that got snapped, and also a whole lot of bark. There's lots of examples of it. This all got pulled off this root, and that's obviously some good feeding or good food for the elephants. Lots of moisture and nutrients in this softer bark, very long stringy bark. That's what the elephant was after. But the good news for the tree is that it's only one of the main roots. There's still another big root. This whole area, this is that little seat. Now over time, many of us have sat here, Jan has sat here, and Marco and different people when they come and gone. But what happened on Tuesday night when I got back from my break, that night we had lots of hyena activity and noises, and we had a leopard in camp, some of you might remember. But the next day we found out that actually the leopard had killed a nyala a little bit further that way, about 50, not even 30 meters away. I followed the tracks, dragged it all the way along, actually across this piece here into this little corner, and this is where the hyena stole it from the leopard. So it was quite an interesting little story that happened last week. It's still a very nice hyena print just in the mud here, which you should be able to make out. It's a few days old, but it's just so perfectly placed in the mud that it's almost like a cast. There you can see the perfect track walking this direction towards me, the heel in the back and the four toes with the very sharp tips at the front and the clear marks on the nails. This is also the overflow, so this is sort of the wall, if you want, of this little pond. But yeah, a bit of work to do again, even though the elephant's landscaping has been quite interesting. Quite like the way this branch protects that seat. It left a whole lot of branches somewhere in the next week or so. At some day we'll play around with it a bit. I'm going to show you along the edge of it a little bit as well. Basically, this is the pond section. This would normally be a bit more open. This has all been broken by the elephants now, but it's all part of the setting. And if you come around a little bit on this side, just to give an idea, it's one of the things I've really enjoyed. All looking good there, Herman. After making this a couple of months ago, obviously in winter, it got a few things going, but now that summer is coming along, you're seeing it getting greener along the edges. But what's really been exciting for me is just noticing how the whole space has changed. Obviously being water that's suddenly available, it's attracted a whole lot of things, everything from small insects and butterflies and dragonflies up to more bird life. Speaking of which, where's this little one? Little bird making a racket here next to us. It's a little Chinspectus. I don't know if you can see it there. Clicking and chirping away. beautiful little bird. So the bird life around here substantially picked up. A lot of smaller, shyer birds. There's a bearded robin that we see around here, white-throated robin, chagra, all kinds of bird life, bushbuck that are very often around Nyala. But also buffalo have started using it more. This little area to my left hasn't been wallowed in now for a few days, but they've sort of decided to change this into a bit of a mud wallow. A couple of buffalo have rolled here before, warthog or two as well. And yeah, so it's just been lovely to see the area naturally develop. Little footpaths opening up. I mean, already there's big footpaths now. Also, obviously, the water that seeps through still has open water for another 30, 40 yards downstream. So it's just been amazing to see this little ecosystem or little micro-environment developing. Just to give an idea of where the water comes from, we're not going to walk into it, but basically all the grey water from camp comes out at the top there and then runs along a bit of a ditch that's been filled up with river sand, so a natural filtering system, and it just filters out through the sand all around here as well. It filters out through these logs and the sand underneath. So by the time it comes out here, it's actually quite clean, and that we can see clearly from how the animals behave around it and in it and drink it. So yeah, it's been a nice little story, and it looks totally different from what it did a few weeks ago. There's some warthog tracks as well, obviously from a wallow. But for the moment, just a quick hello, and to keep you updated, like I said, we will keep you updated from the final control center side as well. But if all goes well, hopefully in the next half an hour, 45 minutes, Rexon will be here with the equipment we need. Sorry, some dove that flew past. There's also a little sparrowhawk, a tiny little raptor that lives in this area. I see him probably one in three times that I walk around here. I thought it was that, but it was just a dove. But yeah, for the moment, thank you for joining us. Stick around, watch the water. There was a giraffe just before we started talking. There might be some more activity as well. And as soon as we can, hopefully in less than an hour, we'll be out there for a bit of a Saturday afternoon drive. Join us for that as well. As always, look forward to seeing you in a little bit. By myself, Peter and Herman, out here at Pete in the Control Center, we'll all be talking to you a little bit. We'll see you out on the drive again soon. Bye-bye. Bye for now, maybe, is better.